A bistable structure is one that has two stable states. So one that most people know already is snap bracelets. So it's stable when it's out flat, and then I provide some input and it snaps through and it's stable like this as well. There's many examples of morphine structures in nature. One that we look at a lot is the Venus flytrap. If this is the leaf of the Venus flytrap, it has one layer with cells that are pre-stressed like this, and then one layer with cells that are pre-stressed like this. And the contrasting pre-stress is what gives it the fast morphing when it snaps closed. And this is very difficult to achieve, but when you're using 3D printing, we can take some complicated geometry like this and just partition it and tell the printer we want to print in, say, this direction for this section and then this direction over here. And once you design this on the computer with the 3D printer, it's still pretty much just plug and play. Right now it's at room temperature, so it's stiff and it's kind of stuck in this pre-stressed state. But then if I heat it up, you get two stable shapes. And then you can snap it back and forth really fast and easily between them because it's elastic. So this technique has an advantage of combining high load carrying capability at room temperature. So right now it's monostable, but it's very stiff. It could carry a lot more weight with low snapping force. So once I heat it up, it's really easy to snap it back and forth. This is a chair design. So this has three different sections and then it prints flat like this. But then if I heat it up, it deforms to this chair shape, and then you can snap the bottom and the back part. So it can become like this lounger shape. Design flexibility that this offers is really exciting. Say you had some tile and you program in, you know, five different stable shapes, then they're flat, so they're really easy to ship. And then on site, you can heat it up and snap it to whichever state you need, and then cool it down and it'll be stiffer and load bearing. With bistable structures, you just need some input force to overcome that energy barrier, and then it does the rest of the work by itself.